every day I will say, Father God, I am yours, I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad, you make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad, I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours, every day I will say, Father God, I am yours, I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad, make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad, I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad, you make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad, I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child of God.
Dear God, thank you for this wonderful day. Let us learn about you more and more. I pray that you will keep us all safe and healthy. Thank you for everything you did for us. I pray in Jesus' name, amen.
You're the reason why our hearts are beating.
Yeah. Joshua is a medium-sized book with 24 chapters that divide into four parts. Part one is about Joshua finally leading the Israelites across the Jordan River and into Canaan, the promised land.
And once again, God parts the waters so they can walk through on dry land.
With the fishes just staring at them.
Not this time. The book of Joshua says the waters of the Jordan River were blocked about 20 miles upstream from the Israelites. So for sure, no fish could watch them cross.
Oh, that's too bad.
What's interesting is that the place the Bible says the waters were stopped is a place where giant mudslides sometimes block the whole river. The last time this happened was in 1927, and the Jordan River was completely blocked for 20 hours.
Wow, so God might have used a mudslide to help the Israelites cross the river.
Mudslide, mudslide, God can use you as a guide. Help me to the other side, mudslide.
Hey, I'm the one singing.
Sorry, it looked fun.
Good morning. I hope you guys had a great Thanksgiving break. I'm sure you guys, some of you guys, lots of turkey and ham and maybe steak. There were just a lot of things that we were grateful for and thankful for to our God. So hopefully you guys had a great time. All right, we came a long way. Today we are on Joshua chapter 11. Okay, we have learned so much about our God and also about Joshua and Israelites. Remember 2 weeks ago, we learned about how God was in full control of the battle against five kings. What happened during the battle? Joshua asked God to do what? Yes, Joshua needed more time to destroy the enemies before sunset. So God made the sun stand still and stopped moon from moving. Do you guys remember? That was amazing what God has done. In chapter 11, they faced another battle. And you guys might think, why so many battles, right? I don't know, but that's just what's in the Bible, what happened in the book of Joshua. So here, another group of kings, northern kings, decide to get together and fight against God's people. What do you think will happen to Joshua and Israelites? Let's read Joshua 11, verse 4 to 5. Those kings marched out with all their troops. They had a large number of horses and chariots. It was a huge army. The fighting men were as many as the grains of sand on the seashore. All those kings gathered their armies together to fight against Israel. They set up camp together at the waters of Merom. Wow, looking at verse 4 and 5, they look pretty tough, right? They came with a large number of horses and chariots, and it was a huge army. And what else does it say? Their fighting men were how many? As many as the grains of sand on the seashore. I know my boys, they love to play with sand in the playground. Can you even count sand? Even just in like little playground, right? They will probably take us forever. But it says, as many as grains of sand on the seashore. That means just lots of people, right? So they gathered together to fight against Israel. So how do you think Israelites felt about this? Do you think they were afraid? Maybe, right? Since there are so many people, horses and chariots were coming after them. Let's read verse 6. The Lord said to Joshua, "Do not be afraid of them. By this time tomorrow, I will hand all of them over to Israel. All of them will be killed. You must cut the legs of their horses. You must burn their chariots." Wow, that was pretty scary, right? So how about now? Do you think Israelites should be afraid? Yes? No? Yeah, probably. I'm thinking maybe they were afraid, but they trusted God, right? And that gave them courage. So because the Lord is fighting for Israel once again. So just as the Lord said, the Lord gave them into the hand of Israel. So throughout the northern conquest, Joshua obeyed all that God had told him to do. Let's look at verse 15. Verse 15, it says, the Lord had commanded his servant Moses to do all these things. Moses had passed the command on to Joshua, and Joshua carried it out. He did everything the Lord had commanded Moses. So yes, God was the one who was protecting Israel and fighting for his people. But also, Joshua obeyed all that God had told him to do. Joshua left nothing undone. Do you and I obey the Lord this completely? We are called to do so because the Lord is fighting our enemies for us. We can have the strength to obey God, just like Joshua. Joshua kept right on conquering his enemies out of obedience to God. So we see again that the Lord is in total control. He hardened the Canaanites' hearts so that they would fight against Israel. And the Lord destroyed them completely as he does to all his enemies. So the Lord fought for Israel because they were his chosen and loved people. The Lord fought for Israel because, once again, they were chosen and loved people. The Lord was cleaning out the land of Canaan, then promised land, so his people could live there in peace. So it was the Lord's work, of course, and Joshua's obedience. So today I have an illustration. Hopefully it will help us to kind of think about our obedience in our daily life. Let's say your mom or dad asks you 10 things. How many times do you guys completely obey your parents? Okay, I want you guys to think about that. I know you guys are probably familiar with this. Happy Meal, right? My kids still, they love Happy Meal. So, but let's see what's inside Happy Meal, this box. Okay, of course, there's a toy. Okay, there's my favorite French fries. And healthy apple slices. I'm gonna just kind of open it right now. Okay. And then I have chicken nuggets. I don't know, I still love chicken nuggets better than burger, I guess. So I have this. So let's just say that your mom, let's see, probably asks you to clean your room every day, right? So you obey your mom, okay? I'm gonna talk about it. And of course, if you need chicken nuggets by itself, it's really good, okay? Oh yeah, I forgot apple juice. There's apple juice. And let's say your mom or dad ask you to do homework. So you do it. It's really good. And what is? Oh, can you help your brother or sister to put on their clothes? And you say, okay, mommy, okay, daddy, I'll obey. Really yummy, okay? And lastly, can you take out the trash in the trash can or outside? So I'm gonna drink this apple juice. And of course, oh, it's really healthy taste, but still good, okay? Let's say you obey. So it's, you know, you're doing good, right? And you're obeying your parents. And let's say, you know, in the morning, your parents say, hey, okay, you woke up, so let's, can you brush your teeth, wash your face? And you say, no, I don't feel like it, right? So you don't obey. And then you say, after school, okay, since class is over, can you do your homework first? And then you can play. And you say, no, mom, I want to play first. I want to do homework tomorrow, okay? So you disobey. Okay. Oh, can you help your brother or sister put on their clothes? You say, no, why do I have to? They can do it by themselves. Okay. Then you keep disobeying. Okay. Okay, stop playing game and come and eat. Okay? That's what your probably mom says all the time. And you say, No, mom, right now I just want to play a game. I want to play a game. Okay? And so you just keep disobeying. Okay? I'm going to just pour the whole apple juice. And of course, there are times that, you know, you just don't feel like obeying. So it's... And what happens? Like when you keep disobeying, I'm going to just save some for myself. When you keep disobeying, what happens? Okay? I mean, in the beginning, it doesn't look as bad, but once you start disobeying, it piles up. Let's see what happens. Okay, maybe some of you guys have to close your ears. What happened? Really bad, but do you see it inside? It looks pretty bad, right? It looks pretty gross. Okay. The guy actually who did this, he actually drank it, but I'm not going to try it. But what am I trying to say? Okay. When you keep disobeying your parents, or when you obey your parents, you're actually disobeying. When you're disobeying your parents, you're disobeying God. I think I did talk about this before. So in your heart, it gets messy and messy when, you know, when you disobey. And, you know, ultimately you need to go back to God and you need to repent for your disobedience. Okay. And this is what happens when we keep disobeying. Our hearts are not pure, are not healthy. So I want you guys to remember this illustration. And, we just had Thanksgiving. And, you know, I think when I asked you guys, during our small group, most of you guys say you're grateful for your parents and our family and your friends, right? So I want you guys to really think about your parents, and not only your parents, your teachers, your pastors. God wants us to obey, right? And God, of course, God wants us to obey our God. So hopefully this will stick with you once again, this illustration, to always be reminded of you guys selves that God wants us to obey. And obedience is better than sacrifice. Okay? All right, let's pray and end our worship. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today's message. I know that it was your work, and you hardened the Canaanites and had them fight against Israel, and you handed them over to Israel. And so it was your battle, and you fought for Israelites. But also there was Joshua's obedience. He did everything that you had commanded him to do. And Lord, that's how we want to live in our daily life. We want to obey. I know it's tough. I know it's not easy. But Lord, give us courage. Give us boldness. Give us heart to obey our parents and obey your words, Father God. We thank you for today's message. And be with us throughout this week. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's end our worship with Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Come on, come on, we'll let it rise, let it rise. God praise right.